And one of the things I did postpartum is like request the nurse to give me like a bunch of supplies to take home, because they give you like all these like pads and mesh underwear, which are amazing because you can just toss them. And so, yeah, just request for them. And if they have extras, they'll give them to you. The other thing is like the baby items in the hospital, like they'll give you like a little comb and like, you know, baby soap. Those baby combs, I don't know where they got them from, but they're so good, especially like postpartum. The baby's a little older and gets like cradle cap. They're so good for scrubbing that off. So take all the things home because you're getting charged for them anyways. I'm Shira Bergbauer, and you're listening to an excerpt from the Stethoscopes to Swaddles podcast. Okay, so cramping is also normal. Now, postpartum, your labor and delivery nurse and your postpartum nurse will massage your uterus to make sure that it's like, just to feel for it and make sure that it's getting massaged and settling in, make sure it expels any excess lochia in there. But cramping is normal because the uterus, again, is trying to get back into its original size after being stretched so much by an infant, right? So as far as C-section, things to look out for: incisional drainage. Just make sure that it's not like, you know, crusty, nasty smelling. Make sure that you check your incision because wound dehiscence can happen where the wound kind of starts opening up. And so just make sure you paying attention to that to make sure that you're not developing an infection. So for both of them, whether you had a vaginal or C-section, breast milk leaking is normal. So if your milk has come in, quote unquote, which I think is the weirdest thing, you're like, your milk comes in, it's just like your oxytocin is now starting to like tell your brain like, hey, give the baby some food. You may notice your breasts leaking when you're not breastfeeding. Engorgement can also happen where the milk ducts fill up and it can be uncomfortable. And you want to make sure that if you do have any knots, you massage them out because you don't want to develop mastitis. Like I said, uterine contractions within the first hours of after birth, the upper portion of the uterus, which is the fundus, is about the level of the navel. And it remains there for about a day and then it gradually starts coming down. If you're breastfeeding, this might actually happen a lot faster. And if there are no complications, the uterus will return to its approximate non-pregnant size, which is the size of a pear, in about 6 weeks. So cramping is just caused by the contractions that stop the bleeding from where the placenta was attached. So if you think about it, the placenta came off. So the body is trying to like control that bleeding. And that it can be intense. And one of the things, especially when you're breastfeeding, that first 5 minutes, it can be so uncomfortable. You literally feel like you're in labor again. Don't be alarmed. It's just the hormones just acting because it can be a little uncomfortable. Like you're like, why is my uterus cramping? The baby is already out. So that's why. You can also have contractions in your bladder when you're urinating just because also the bladder is trying to go back to its original position. So that's normal. Mood changes are also normal. And I want to make a point here that there's a period where you feel down and anxious, and that's normal. That's called the baby blues, and it includes mood swings, crying spells, anxiety, and difficulty sleeping. The point to note here is that the baby blues usually subside within 2 weeks. So if it extends to that, then and it becomes like severe mood swings, loss of appetite, overwhelming fatigue, and just feeling like lack of joy in life shortly after childbirth, this might be a red flag for postpartum depression. So pay attention to your emotional state postpartum. I know everybody's asking you about baby. Everybody wants to know what's going on with the baby. Nobody's really asking you about you. So pay attention to you. Constipation. So the first bowel movement after delivery may be delayed about, you know, 3 to 4 day after delivery. And your provider may prescribe or recommend an over-the-counter stool softener to make the stool softer and bowel movements less uncomfortable. So in this period, you really want to be eating more fruits, vegetables, increasing whole grains, increasing fiber, and drinking plenty of water. Because remember, again, that area has been stretched out so much. And so the pressure of just like trying to have a bowel movement can be very uncomfortable. I personally like kind of cheated the code. I took stool softeners with me to the hospital, and postpartum, I just started taking Colace, and it still was like you have like the anticipated PTSD when you go to the bathroom the first time, but you will survive. It's okay. And sometimes if you have a lot of pain postpartum, they may give you narcotic pain relievers, and that just makes constipation worse. So if you're not super uncomfortable and they offer you narcotics, you're like, you can say no. You don't have to take everything they give you. And sitz baths are really good with this if you're having discomfort, especially if hemorrhoids start to develop or you had hemorrhoids pre-baby. This is a one thing that nobody told me about that as I was looking through the research for this episode, I'm so glad I found this information. Perspiration, sweating. It's common after delivery to have like increased sweating, especially at night, because your body is adjusting to new hormone levels. So it's very interesting because you literally are like, you can break into a sweat, like a heavy, heavy sweat, and you could develop chills. So what you need to do is make sure that you shower, you change your clothes, and you change your linen so that you're not sitting in like soaked wet beddings. And also like increase your fluids because you're again losing fluids, and your body is also trying to conserve the fluids to save milk, to make milk for the baby. So just a reminder, like the sweating can be a lot, but it's part of the hormone adjustments. These dang hormones, like they're just everywhere. So what are emergency symptoms that you need to call your doctor about? If you have a fever of 104 or severe chills, if you have foul-smelling vaginal discharge, if the lochia continues to be bright red and continues beyond day 3 postpartum, if you're passing large blood clots that are larger than a plum, if you have severe pain or burning when you're trying to urinate, and severe cramping or abdominal pain that is not relieved by pain medication. Again, remember I said that uterine cramping is normal, but if you're trying to take something and it doesn't go away, it's just call your physician. If the vaginal discharge or bleeding continues to increase instead of decrease and you're using more than one pad per hour, that's a red flag. You need to call your doctor. Blurred vision, severe headaches or passing out, increased pain. If you've had a C-section, if you notice redness, drainage, or separation of the incision, important to call your doctor.
I'm Shira Bergbauer, and you're listening to an excerpt from the Stethoscopes to Swaddles podcast. You can listen to the whole episode wherever you get your podcasts, and look out for new episodes out every Monday. You're doing a great job, Mama. I'll see you next week. Bye now.